Thank you. Thank you very much indeed. Welcome once again, ladies and gentlemen, to another edition of 321. And we've got a one-hour package for you of pop music from the past. Our theme this week is a great theme, the Swinging Sixties. Swinging Sixties, when one in every three born was a Chinaman. Today it's a Nolan sister. No, it's a great time. We all lived through that marvellous time. You know, people were thrown up, like Elvis Presley, of course, the Beatles. Do you know, I was with Rolf Harris when he got his number one hit. And it was a gimmick of Rolf Harris. He didn't know he'd get this gimmick. He had a tough steak one night, and he went, sunrise, spring in the morning, spreading all the light all around. Who dealt with you? Del Shannon. Remember him with a high voice? I wonder. Remember him? Ellen Shapiro? Whoa, whoa, whoa. He sang like a woman, she sang like a man, and they wonder why the kids were mixed up. But here's a little character we want you to come along and meet, because these days everyone's into modern music, but here's some heavy metal our contestants certainly will want to get rid of. That's our resident booby prize, my little mate Dusty Bin. Here he is. How's he? There he is. Dressed up, of course. He's either John, Paul, George, or Ringo, whatever he is. He's the Beatle our contestants certainly have to beat. And let's come along right now and meet the folks without whom we just wouldn't have a show. Ladies and gentlemen, our contestants. Here they are.
Kevin and Mandy Abbott from Chester. Bill and Melanie James from Truro. Terry and Sue Smith from Barnard Castle.
And our first couple tonight are Sue and Terry Smith, and you're from Barnard Castle, County Durham. Cootie doodum, huh?
Yeah.
Lovely. And what do you do up there then, Terry? What do you do for a living?
I'm a job evaluation officer. Work for a pharmaceutical firm.
Uh-huh. And you don't work anymore, Sue, do
no,
you?
No, I used to work for the same firm
same
as a secretary.
And you have a family now?
Yes, I have two, yes.
Two what? What are they?
A little girl and a little boy.
Lovely. Yes. Good to have you here. I see. So what do you turn out? Pills and capsules and tablets and
stuff?
Yes,
injectable items, creams, all sorts of medicinal things.
Yeah. Make sure you're all just thinking about it. Now, what about you do, you've got some very good sort of hobbies here. You grow vegetables. Is that the both of you do this?
Well, yes, we tend to grow both of us. But I'm take charge of the show. Vegetables.
Yes. And short ones. And you make woodwork. You're into woodwork, sir.
Yes, yes. I don't have so much time now the children are here, but I have made all sorts. Garden benches, bookcase, and...
Puts us all to shame, things. Terry,
doesn't
it?
Yes.
Well done. Well, it's nice you're here. Good luck, and we'll see you in a moment in the quiz. Second couple, we've got Mandy and Kevin. They are from another lovely part of the world, Chester.
That's right, yeah.
Lovely city. I like that very much. What do you do up there, Kev?
I'm a second-hand car dealer.
He said that as though it was worse than the VAT man, didn't he?
No, they're the worst.
And Mandy, do you work at all?
No, I used to be a teacher, but I've got a little girl, Mary, now.
Little girl, Mary, I see. How old is she?
She's 17 months.
I see. Well, what's all this about you two having a whirlwind romance?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah?
We limited it to 11 years.
Yeah.
11?
11? Yes, well, very good at making decisions.
11 years? What took you so long? I mean, what happened?
Well, it was usually a choice between a holiday or getting married, and we went for a holiday.
Well, it wasn't so much a courtship as an MOT, wasn't
that?
Mandy on test. Anyway, good you're both here. Our third couple tonight, Melanie and Bill. They're from another lovely part of the world. You're from Truro. Truro down there in Cornwall, of course. And what do you do down there, Bill?
I work in tin mine. I'm underground maintenance fitter.
Mm-hmm. And are you working at all, Melanie, these days?
Extremely busy housewife.
You also have children too?
Two
as well, that's good. Tin mine, how deep do those mines go then?
Well, ours is about 1,500 feet.
1,500?
Yeah.
And have you always done that?
Most of the time, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I see you used to work in a diamond mine.
Yeah, well, when the mines closed down, I went to Africa for a year. And...
Well, I was going to ask you if you had any tin samples, but now you're really talking. Like
no free samples
no,
at all.
Because diamond is the hardest substance known to man, isn't it? To get back from a woman.
That's right.
So they tell me. And you play cricket, yes?
I try, yes.
Are the team all right?
Yeah, when I play, I don't know.
That's what I like, somebody who's got no big deal about himself. Lovely. Glad the two of you are here. Okay, let's get on with our quiz. Now, remember, we have two rounds of questioning. They play for £10 for each correct answer in the first round, but whatever they win at the end of the first round is the amount they play for each correct answer in the second round. Now, at the end of the quiz, the couple with the lowest amount of money will leave us at that point. So let's get on with the quiz and meet the lady who has the questions. Caroline Munro is here. If you didn't hear what I said at the top of the show, the Swinging Sixties really is the theme of our show this week.
They
really walked around like that, huh?
I suppose they did.
I can remember, but he seems that long ago. Let's bring them back, that's what I say. Caroline, nice you're here. Let's go and get over with the questions to our first couple. There you are, Terry and Sue. One of those envelopes is for you. That's the one? Okay, good. Good luck to you. Hold nice and tightly, that's right. Now, you know what happens here, of course. We like you to answer alternately, ladies first. Two ways we can stop you if you make a mistake or run out of time. If you don't know an answer, just say, don't know, pass, and I'll go on to your partner with the next question. So be careful of guesses. But I must stress that I must accept the first answer you give me, all right? So think about that, and of course, we will let you have one to start with. Now, this question here is about records that reached number one in this country during the 60s. We will give you the name of a record, and we want you to give us the name of the performer or group that made it. So, number one hits of the 60s. Now, the Ballad of Bonnie and Clyde was a hit for Georgie Fame. We'll start you with that one. The Ballad of Bonnie and Clyde was a hit for...
Georgie Fame.
Congratulations.
Cliff Richards.
Wooden Heart.
Elvis Presley.
The Last Waltz.
Pass.
You're My World.
Pass.
Poor Me.
Pass.
Walking Back to Happiness.
Sandy Shaw.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. It wasn't Sandy Shaw. I heard somebody buzz it in the audience. Oh, would you like to keep quiet if you wouldn't mind, because it's a bit difficult up here. It was Helen Shapiro. Walking Back to Happiness. Yeah. Whoop-a, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. That was another one. Sorry about that. Poor Me, Adam Faith. Poor Me. Do you remember Adam Faith?
Yeah.
That was his. You're My World. Can you think of that now?
No.
That was Cilla Black, and the last waltz was?
Engelbert Humperdinck,
I'm afraid.
Yeah.
Anyway, what do you have there? You've got three rights. So at the end of that, you have £30. Yes, you do. £30. That's okay. A nice start. Hey, Caroline. Andy and Trevor, one of those two is for you. Thank you. That's the one. Same thing. Yeah, they're holding tightly. I don't even have to tell them to do that these days. Okay. Don't forget, if you don't know an answer, say don't know or pass. This question here is about records that reached number one in this country during the 60s. We will give you the name of the record. We want you to give us the name of the performer or the group that made it. Number one hits of the 60s. Lily the Pink was a hit for The Scaffold. We'll start you with that one. Lily the Pink and...
The Scaffold.
Hey Jude.
The Beatles.
Bachelor Boy.
Pass.
My Old Man's a Dustman.
Lonnie Donegan.
It's Now or Never. These Boots Are Made for Walking.
Nancy Sinatra.
The Green, Green Grass of Home.
Tom Jones.
Puppet on a String.
Sandy Shaw.
Massachusetts.
Huh?
Moon River.
Danny Williams.
Indeed it was, Danny Williams. There you are, well done. Yes, a ripple. Well done, yes, Kevin. Now, Massachusetts. Was the Bee Gees. Do you remember that? I'm going back to Massachusetts. Another one.
Man,
what else? It's Now or Never was Elvis Presley, of course. And what else with the other one? Bachelor Boy. Can you think now?
Cliff Richard.
Indeed, it was Cliff Richard. So at the end of that, what have you scored? You have got £70. Seven right. Well done. Oh, yeah. Nice. Okay, Melanie, the last envelope. So that's the one for you and Bill. So good luck to you. And they're not holding hands.
No.
Is it something he said? Okay, this question is about records that reached number one in this country during the 60s. We will give you the name of the record. We want you to give us the name of the performer or group that made it. Number one hits of the 60s. I Remember You was a hit. Great mate of mine, Frank Ifield. We'll start you with that one. I Remember You and...
Frank Ifield.
Are You Lonesome Tonight?
Don't know.
Get Back.
The Beatles.
The House of the Rising Sun.
Pass.
Those Were the Days.
Mary Hopkins.
Summer Holiday.
Cliff Richard.
A Whiter Shade of Pale.
Boko Haram.
Tears.
Ken Dodd.
Baby Love.
Pass.
The Carnival Is Over.
Pass.
Ah, again, I work with them a heck of a lot. The Carnival Is Over was the Seekers. Yes? I think you nearly knew Baby Love, didn't you? You went
the
like
Supremes.
That. The Supremes. You couldn't take the chance. Baby Love was the Supremes, and the House of the Rising Sun was the Animals. Yes?
The Animals.
Are you lonesome tonight?
Are you lonesome tonight?
Elvis Presley. Didn't sound a bit like him. At the end of that, though, you've got what? Six, right? Is it? £60 you have. Well done. Nice. So, at the end of the first round of our quiz, Sue and Terry up there, couple number one have got £30. Indy, we've got Bill and Melanie, couple number three on £60 in the lead at the moment, couple number two. Mandy and Kevin, they've got £70. Off we go, still holding tightly. Round two questions from Caroline. One of those three is for you. Who's choosing? Terry this time? Good. Okay, Terry, good luck. £30 for you for each correct answer. And this question here is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters L-E. L-E. We will give you a definition. We want you to give us the word. Words beginning with L-E. The 40 days before Easter is Lent, so that's what we'll start you with. The 40 days before Easter is?
Lent.
A yellow citrus fruit.
Lemon.
Communication through the post.
Letter.
Association of sporting clubs.
Pass.
Story handed down from the past.
Legend.
Time for relaxation and rest.
Leisure.
The circle of a glass in a camera.
Lens.
A teacher in a college.
Lecturer.
A bookkeeper's large book.
Ledger.
And describes a year of 366 days. Just beat us. Delia, well done, Terry. Leap year, I'm sure you knew that one. What else did we... Association of Sporting Clubs, do you know that now?
No.
One you couldn't take a chance on, league. It was as simple as league, yes. So at the end of that, what have you scored there? You've got £240. Good. Okay. Second round questions. Mandy, thank you very much. Caroline, so for £70 for each correct answer this time, your question is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters B-E. We will give you a definition. You give us the word. Words beginning with B-E. A bird's bill is a beak. We'll start you with that one. A bird's bill is a...
beak.
Piece of furniture for sleeping on.
Bed.
Insect that makes honey.
Bee.
Person who pleads for money.
Beggar.
Long seat for several people.
Bench.
The roar of a bull.
Pass.
The state of uproar.
Bedlam.
Another name for deadly nightshade.
Sorry, I don't know.
Capital of East Germany.
Berlin.
Wanderers in the Arabian desert.
Bedouins.
Yes, Bedouins was right. Right on the buzzer there. The, another name for deadly nightshade was belladonna.
Oh.
Yes. The roar of the bull was a bellow. It was as simple as that one. Yeah. So at the end of this one, this round, you have scored. What have we got? 565. 560. Nice. Lovely. Thanks, Caroline. Thank you. Okay, Melanie and Bill, you're going for £60 for each correct answer. And your question, again, is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters A-T. We will give you the definition, you give us the word. Words beginning with A-T. Now, a string of coral islands is an atoll. We'll start you with that one. A string of coral islands is an...
atoll.
A book of maps.
Atlas.
Person who's good at sport.
Athlete.
Clothes.
Attire.
Capital of Greece.
Pass.
Scent bottle with a fine spray.
Atomizer.
Producer of the film Gandhi.
Pass.
Describes a small suitcase for papers.
Attaché.
A brutal and cruel act.
Attack.
Greek goddess of wisdom.
Athos.
Ah, near it, so close, but not quite. Not Athos, Athena. That was one of the three musketeers. We wanted Athena, or Athena. Whatever, that's the one, never mind. The producer of the film Gandhi was Attenborough, of course.
Yeah.
That was the one I saw you do that again. And the other one was the capital of Greece.
Athens.
Athens, you know. At the end of that, you have scored £420. Yeah. Well done. Lovely. So... the two letters given to each of our couples this week spelt out B-E-A-T-L-E, Beatle, tying in, of course, with this week's theme of those swinging 60s. But at the end of the quiz, this week we have Sue and Terry up there. They've got £240. We've got Bill and Melanie. They've got £420. But the winners, same as the end of round one, then Mandy and Kevin have got £560. Well done. Lovely, lovely. Well, Sue and Terry, we have to say goodbye to you right now, which is a bit of a shame. It's only seemed like a couple of minutes to us, but it seemed like forever and a day to you, isn't it? But they've been a marvellous couple, you really have. There's the money, of course, the £240. Sue's very nice. She lets Terry take that. There's that ceramic dusty bin. I'm sure you wanted that more than anything else, didn't you? Anyway, lovely that you're with us. Thank you very much, Terry. Sue. Thank you, folks. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. We're going away for the break. We'll be back in just a couple of minutes on 3, 2, 1. We'll see you in just a minute. Mine, here you go. Okay, it's part two of 3, 2, 1, and this week's theme, of course, the Swinging Sixties. We've got Bill and Melanie, who are from Truro down there in Cornwall, and they're against this time Kevin and Mandy, of course, are not far away, really, Chester. Okay, you know what happens here, of course. We have three items to show you. At the end of each one of the items, one of our guest stars will come to the table, leave you a clue object, and read you a rhyme. When we have three on the table, I'm going to ask you to select one you'd like to reject if you're the lucky couple to get through to part three with the chance to take home a fabulous prize, or hopefully not, dusty bin. You know what happens. Let's get on then with our theme of the Swinging Sixties. Now we're going back to a gentleman who's been around so long, I think he's got his own rail pass. But the date is the 15th of April, 1963.
Now then, you would not believe the atmosphere what we have here in the studio tonight. And that is because we have a young man who is not only this week's number one, but was also last week's number one as well, and all that with his very first record. It's the knockout, fantastic, super, super wonderful Gerry and the Pacemakers. And we might well ask him, how do you do it? How do you do what you do to me? I wish I knew. If I knew how you do it to me, I'd do it to you. You give me a feeling in my heart, like an arrow passing through it. Suppose that you think you're very smart, but won't you tell me, how do you do it? How do you do what you do to me? If I only knew, perhaps you'd fall for me like I fell for you. I like it. I like the way you run your fingers through my hair. And I like the way you tickle my chin. And I like the way you let me come in when your mama ain't there. Your mama ain't there. Do that again. You're driving me insane. Kiss me once more, 'cause that's another thing I like you for. I like it. I like the funny feeling being here with you. And I like it more with every day. And I like it always hearing you say you're liking it too. You're liking it too. Oh, come. Oh, come. With hope in your heart. And you
it's been made to Jerry.
Great to be here,
yes. Hey, listen, Jerry, the last time we met was a long way away now.
Yes, sir.
You remember where that was?
It was Double Bay, Australia.
That's right, in Sydney, eh?
That's right.
Yeah, you go, I mean, you're around the world a lot these days, aren't
yes,
you?
Yes, we're
not just Australia.
But 7 months we do the States, Singapore, Germany, Holland.
See, Life is tough for the Mersey Sound. It's not doing very well these days. Marvellous. It's really good to see you doing so well. And in such great voice there, and the guys. What are you going to leave these folks then, Gerry?
Right.
The clue.
They got a tin can.
A tin can is a clue.
And it says, something tiny and the start of a song with one of Gerry's group along.
And that's it. A nice nifty one for you. How's that? No idea, and there's only two lines to it. Ladies and gentlemen, Gerry Marvin. Thanks, Gerry. Thanks a lot. Yes, our rhymes, they're more couplets these days. It's just a couple of lines. Any idea what they could be? No?
I like it. Yeah. Metal could be a car. Can could be...
You see, it could be one or two or 20,000 things, even in two lines. What do you think, Kevin?
They sometimes call those speakers can, so it could be a high five.
Could well be, couldn't it? All right then, good. Mandy agrees with you. Let's get on. Let's have item number two. This time we're going back to that little gentleman again. Little gentleman, that old gentleman, Jimmy Savile.
Now, as it happens, we have got for you something very, very special. We have a young lady what has a massive hit on her hands on account of how she wants to become a copper's girlfriend. It's the fabulous, fabulous, double fabulous Susan Maughan, and I Want to Be Bobby's Girl. Bless my soul.
And singing up so well. I mean, it's great to see you here. Thank you for coming.
Thanks.
And you're busier than anyone else, of course.
Well, I'm
Panto?
Working.
Panto
yes,
this year with
Birmingham,
aren't you?
Alex, yeah. With lovely, lovely John Inman, yeah. Mother Goose.
Yeah.
And I'm principal boy. You wouldn't believe in this prop,
would you? Nobody will believe that. But listen, it's a lovely theatre, the Alex.
Yes.
You're
indeed.
Having many happy times.
Having
there.
A marvellous, yeah, wonderful season.
Good you're here with us. And what are you going to leave them as a clue?
Well, a mouse.
Oh, here you are. Here you are. A mouse is the clue. And how about your aunt?
The Swinging Sixties was quite a time. Bobby's Ma's Pa might help with the rhyme.
Doesn't help me much either, no? Don't worry, I haven't got to worry about it. You have. Thank you very much indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, Susan Maughan. Thank you, sir. Good luck. There you are. So what do you think? Any idea at all? Nothing, huh? Yeah, that's
Bobby's
what you think.
Bobby's Ma's Pa's grandband.
Ah, yeah, so that's serious. Got Melanie going a bit.
Bobby's mother.
Yeah. Well, okay, we've got two on the table, one more. Then, of course, we're going to make up our minds what you're going to reject if you are the lucky couple to get through. So we're going to go back to those swinging 60s and you know who. Item number three.
Now then, now. Here we are back in the Eddie days of 1964. And in 1964, there weren't many Eds like mine. Goodness gracious me. We have a young man who appears to be a bit unhappy-like. Not to worry, not to worry. It is the marvellous, marvellous Mr. Dave Berry and the crying game. But as it happens with a string of its to his name, he should be crying all the way to the bank. How's about that then?
You do make me glad. I'm in love with little things that you say. Make me glad that I feel this way. The way you smile, the way you hold my hand, and when I'm down, you tell me I'm your man. You know I love those little things that I hear. Those little things you whispered in my ear. I know there ain't nobody else like you. No one can do the little things you do.
Like everyone we had on the show here tonight, I mean, everyone's so busy, and I know you're abroad, or you've either just been or you're just going again, aren't you?
Yes, I've just made a new record just before Christmas. Mm-hmm.
Is that an album or a single?
It's a single, but it's an old Billie Holiday song, because I've always liked the blues, and it's called Strange Fruit.
Ah.
So we're looking forward to that being released sometime in the new year. And then at the end of January, I'm off to Holland and Belgium and Germany again for a month.
So listen, Strange Fruit, you said, is the title.
That's right, yes.
And I believe that's what the clue is there, isn't it?
I believe so, yes. And no comments, no comments, yes.
Now, what this is the clue. Now, what is that? I know what they think it is, but what do you think?
Two berries.
It's two berries. Two berries. Okay, Dave. And what about the rhyme?
Right, and the clue is, winning's the name of the game, this thing may be the same.
Again, short and sweet. What do you say there, Melanie? Any idea? Randy? Kevin, they've got to really make up their mind right here and now. Oh, gosh, is the cry. Anyway, thanks very much indeed, Dave. Good luck with the record.
Thank you, Dave.
Good luck with the tour. Dave Berry, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Dave. Melanie. Well, here we are. Two berries you've just heard from Dave there. I can read the other two again as we now have three on the table. The first one, remember, was brought in by Gerry of the Pacemakers. Gerry brought in a tin can and he said, something tidy and the start of a song with one of Gerry's group along. That was what Gerry said. Mm-mm. Okay, and the mouse was brought in by Susan Maughan. Susan said, the swinging 60s was quite a time. Bobby's Ma's Pa might help with the rhyme. Now, you heard them all again. So we're at the moment where you've got to choose which one you'd like to reject if you are the lucky couple to get through. So what do you think, Bill? Melanie, any idea what you want to get rid of?
No, you can. Go on.
With the berries.
You want to get rid of the berries if you get through? Okay, which one are you going to choose to reject?
The mouse.
You want to get rid of the mouse if you get through? Okay, that's your decision. Fair enough. We're at the elimination question time. Now, you know what happens here. Here's the question. I shall start to read this. We want you to put your hands beside the button, OK? When I start to read it, if you think you know the answer, hit the button and answer. If you answer before hitting the button, I must offer it to the other couple. Of course, if they're wrong, I'll continue reading it until somebody, of course, gets it right. So good luck to you. Here is the elimination question. This is the most successful instrumental group of all... Okay, Bill, hit the button.
Beatles.
No, it's not the Beatles. I can offer it to Kevin and Mandy. You came in like a flash there.
The Shadows.
Indeed, it is the Shadows. That's it. It was the Shadows. Wowie.
Oh, my. Oh, God.
You see? It's one of those terrible things. You either take the chance or you don't. The key word, of course, was instrumental there. Sure. That's right. Beatles, yeah. I don't think there's any doubt of the greatest group of all time. But the boys had a total, here you are, 303 weeks in the charts at one time, the Shadows spent, apart from backing Cliff Richard down again. However, that's marvellous. That means you've got through. And we have to say, unfortunately, goodbye to Melanie and Bill right now. But not to worry. You never go away empty-handed here. You've got money from the quiz. Caroline, how much?
£420.
£420 it was. How about that? That can't be bad. That's ceramic dusty bin. Always a pleasure to have, of course. And Melanie and Bill, just take a little look across there, because there we've got a nostalgia package for you. It's 17 Beatles albums. Look at that. Oh, brilliant, she says. Brilliant. Lovely. Marvellous. What about that? Yeah, fantastic. It's been lovely having you here, Melanie. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
Good luck. A lovely trip back to Cornwall. Give them a round of applause. Bill, Melanie, off you go. Thank you. Ah, wouldn't mind that present. I tell you what, if you win Dusty Bin, you wouldn't mind it at all, would you? But that's one of those things, eh, Bill? He took that chance, and there you are. Instrumental was the key word there. That means, of course, you are through. And refresh my memory, you have rejected the berries.
No, the mouse.
Oh, the mouse. Sorry, the mouse is going. All right, then. We'll be back in just a couple of minutes to see exactly what that is. See you in 3, 2, 1. Okay. Welcome to part 3, 3, 2, 1, the Swinging Sixties. We are now left with Kevin and Mandy, who come from that lovely city of Chester. They're through here to part 3, hopefully, to take home a good prize tonight. Anyway, we know what you've rejected. Item number 2, the mouse, which was brought in by Susan Maughan, who said, the Swinging Sixties was quite a time. Bobby's Ma's Pa might help with the rhyme. What did you think it was, Mandy?
Grandfather's clock.
That's what you think it was, and you don't need one of those if it is one.
No?
No,
no,
I see. You got enough clocks at home?
Yeah.
Okay. The Swinging Sixties was quite a time. Well, with the mention of time, sixties could have meant seconds or minutes, or if they were swinging, perhaps a pendulum clock, as you suggest. That would give the mouse, which Susan brought in, something to run up. Bobby's Ma's Pa would be a grandfather, as again you suggest, and that should have told you what sort of clock it was. In fact, you're absolutely right. This magnificent grandfather clock with inlaid brass facings. Well, Kevin, Mandy, absolutely right. What about the prize? Would that have gone in at home?
It wouldn't have fitted on top of the telly.
The telly would have gone on top of that, I think. It's a tremendous prize, though, isn't it?
It's lovely,
really,
yeah.
Really a fabulous prize. Of course, it's 3 to 1. You know, that costs quite a bit of money. But I must say, you worked that out very well. You're absolutely right with your assumption. Another fabulous prize has gone, of course, which means we've got to think about getting rid of Dusty Bin for you to take home a good one. So right now, we're going back for item number 4 to Jimmy, you know who.
Thank you. Now, guys and girls, we have got ourselves a bit of a problem. Oh, dearie me, dearie Lord, yes. Because. Here we are in the 60s, about to pay tribute to 4 young men who had no fewer than 17 number one hits. But to do it, we have a group of young ladies and young gentlemen who, in the 60s, was all still in their prams. Or so they claim. See what you think.
So call on me, and I'll send it along with love from me.
for money. Money can't buy me love. I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today.
I think it's today. Yeah.
The girl that's driving me mad is going away.
Is going away.
She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. And she don't care. Oh, yeah, I'll tell you something.
You wouldn't know it was Chris Emmett, not much, would
you?
No. It gets worse and worse. You get older and older as it goes on. It's marvellous. What's going to be the clue then, Chris?
The clue, there, I'm leaving you a burger.
Oh,
there you go.
A burger.
How about that?
Yes.
Hey?
Yes, that could go before the show's over. And what about the rhyme?
Now then, what have we here? We have this. By Jove, is it double tough, this one? Between I Feel Fine and Help, you will find with two magic EPs your own peace of mind. Mm. Goodness gracious me.
How they?
Magical mystery time.
Oh. How about Mandy? What do you say to that? That's all she says. Home. All we're going to do is thank Chris Emmett, alias Jimmy Savile. Thanks,
and
Chris.
The fabulous Brian Rogers connection.
Yes. I won't forget the Brian Rogers. No. Glad to say that. That marvellous Beatles medley there with the Brian Rogers connection. Fabulous dancers. Everything they do is marvellous. But there you are. Chris has just left that again for you, the burger. What do you think it could be?
Well, between I Feel Fine and Help, mm-hmm. and if you won the bin, you'd shout Help, and a beef burger is trash food.
Well, trash food? Well, it's not when I eat it. Can't be bad. Well, anyway, you've just heard that. I can read the can again, which was brought in by Gerry, or the two berries, which was brought in by Dave Berry, of course. Mm-hmm. Which one would you want to hear out of these two?
The berries.
The berries? Yes, okay. Dave Berry said, winning's the name of the game. This thing may be the same. It's what he said. So, there you are, three on the table.
We thought that two berries and another berry...
Yeah, would be what?
Would be
three berries.
Three
berries.
Got it,
yeah.
Say on a fruit machine, so maybe it's a holiday to Las Vegas or somewhere.
Oh, I see. So what does that mean?
We like to think high, you know.
Yeah. What do you think, audience? They don't care either.
No, I'll have the burger.
Because it looks so unhappy.
You want to have the burger, or do you want to get rid of it?
Get rid of it.
We're going to get rid of it.
You're going to get rid of the burger, brought in, okay, just now by Chris Emmett. Whoops. Anyway, don't lose those. Chris Emmett has just said, between I Feel Fine and Help, you will find with two magic EPs your own peace of mind. Now then, okay. I Feel Fine and Help. Okay, we're two Beatles number ones, as you suggest there, and between them there was another. Two magic EPs. The Beatles also had a hit with a double EP. If you'd piece these together, Ticket to Ride and Magical Mystery Tour, you should have thought of a holiday, but where? Now, the Beatles were connected, of course, with Liverpool, but we'd send you a little further than Liverpool usually. Of course, they also had a connection with somewhere else. Can you think where that would be?
America?
Well, yes, they did, but of course, Chris brought you in a burger. There you are. And of course, they started off, if you remember, right, in Hamburg. It's a 3-2-1 holiday to Hamburg is what it is. Take a look at this. Fly you to Hamburg Airport and then by private car to your first class hotel where cocktails and wine and flowers awaited your arrival. Reservations would have been made there for you to dine at the revolving TV tower and at many of the other excellent restaurants. Excursions available to you to include a steamer trip on the Ulster, a musical at the Hansa Theatre, and visits to shopping centres and many other places of interest. You could have taken time out to linger over a stein of beer and just watch the world pass by, or perhaps a visit to the clubs where the Beatles played in their old Hamburg days. The choices were all there for you on a fabulous 3-2-1 holiday. Kev, what do you say to that?
That's life.
Yes, life indeed. A marvellous prize, and it's been rejected, so at least the burger can go away, right? Okay.
It didn't look very appetizing.
Didn't look appetizing, but the holiday did. Yeah. I'm sure you could have done with that. Yeah. Okay, we're going now back to Jimmy Savile for our last item, and remember, we haven't got rid of you-know-who.
No.
Just yet. Okay, Jimmy, item number five, please.
Ah, now, guys and girls, we have one of the greatest all-out chartbusters of all time, and no mistake, because, in any week from November 1961 to December 1962, you would find this super smash it knockout record in the UK charts, and that is the best ever, and so is the artist, guys and gals. It is a gentleman who has, in his mouth, as it happens, an instrument nearly as big as my cigar. It is the one and only Mr. Acker, Bilk.
Senorina Bonacera. It is time to say goodnight to Napoli. Yes, hard for us to whisper Bonacera with that old moon above the Mediterranean Sea. The morning Senorina will go walking where the mountains and the sun come into sight. And by that little jewelry shop we'll stop and linger. I'll buy a wedding ring for your finger. But in the meantime, let me tell you that I love you. Oh, Santa, Senorita, kiss me goodnight. Marvellous
Acker, as always. Now, just a minute, what's going to be the clue here?
There's a clue. This is a pin.
It's not a pin, it's a needle.
Oh, it's a needle. Well, I always get a needle anyway.
So, what does the rhyme say?
Do you want to hear it, Ted?
Yes, please.
Broadway or Tin Pan Alley, in style with us, you'll dally.
Now then.
Don't dilly dally.
Yeah. Ah, see? Well, at least she's dined in there with
Tin Pan Alley.
Tin Pan Alley.
Straight off.
Yes.
Straight off.
Not bad at all.
Good luck in the Middle East. You're going out there very soon, huh?
Probably get a bit oiled.
I'm sure you will, eh? Lovely to the
nice
lovely
to see
you
see
come
you,
here. All
Be
the
good.
Best. Good luck to the
good
guys.
Good luck, darling.
Here we go. Just a little Oliver there. Now, you've just heard that from Acker. Well, which one are you going to read? Yeah, I can read you the can again, which was brought in by Gerry again, or the two berries brought in by Dave Berry. Which one would you like to hear?
The berries.
Yes?
I want to hear that one.
You want to hear?
Do you want to hear that one?
Yes.
Yes?
Please.
All right. Dave Berry said, winning's the name of the game, this thing may be the same, is what he said. Last three on the table, one has to be rejected. Which one's going?
We've decided that isn't a holiday now.
Have we? Yes. We wouldn't have two on one show, maybe.
We thought
D.B.
Dave Berry. Mm-hmm. D.B. Dusty Bin. Mm-hmm. And he sings The Crying Game.
Ah. So?
So perhaps that's the bin, we hope.
So one has to go. Which one?
Berries, please.
Yes. Is that all right, audience? Yep. Yes, that's it. I think we're going to say yeah before they go. Okay. The two berries have been rejected from Dave Berry. Winning's the name of the game. This thing may be the same, is what Dave said. Now then. They brought you in two berries, which meant to indicate two berry songs, which he sang, The Crying Game and Little Things. Winning's the name of the game. So winning this might have meant The Crying Game. This thing might be the same, a little thing. Well, there's only one small prize. Dusty Bin, you've done it, yeah. Yeah. Oh. Bye-bye, Dusty. Oh, the feeling of relief here. And you know, they've loved these so much, the audience. I think you'd like these as a keepsake, wouldn't you? Right, okay. There's marvellous for you there. At least that's been rejected. The dreaded Dusty Bin has gone, which means a good prize goes home with you tonight. We're down to the last two on the table. I can read them both again. Remember, number one item brought in by Gerry, the tin can. He said, something tiny and the start of a song with one of Gerry's group along. Gerry said that. The needle, just brought in by Acker Bilk. Acker said, Broadway or Tin Pan Alley, in style with us, you'll dally. So there you have it, Kevin. One's got to be rejected.
Well,
it's entirely up to you.
We know we've got a lovely prize, so we'll keep the can, shall we?
Oh, right.
What do you want to do?
I'll let Mandy decide, I insist.
Come on, Mandy, it's up to you.
The can.
We'll keep the can.
You will keep the can? That's okay, is it, Kevin?
Wrong.
Yes?
Yes, fine.
All right, you're going to keep the can, which means the needle is rejected?
I don't want a vampire kit.
You don't want a vampire kit. All right, you're rejecting the needle. Acker said, Broadway or Tin Pan Alley, in style with us, you'll dally. No idea what it is, huh? Broadway or Tin Pan Alley were both, of course, those, of course, are music centres, in style with us. Put those together, you do get stylus, which is a modern version of the old needle. And what a modern version this is. You're right, this microcomputer-controlled music center. Take a look at this. The best you can get. It combines everything. It combines radio, record deck, cassette recorder, all of which are controllable by an infrared remote master control. Easy listening. It's never been easier. A wonderful prize, but it's been rejected. It has to go. Take it away, please. Oh. Here we are. This is the moment. This was the first item brought in, number one by Gerry. Gerry brought you in the tin can, something tiny and the start of a song with one of Gerry's group along. Any idea? No mind what you hope. Any idea?
Not really.
All right, let's see what it is. Gerry brought you in the can. Could it be a Gerry can? I don't think so. Not now Dusty Bin's gone. Something tiny and the start of a song. Well, one of the songs in Gerry's medley was You'll Never Walk Alone. Now, the start of that is You'll Never Walk. With one of Gerry's group along, that's a pacemaker. Well, I'm sure you could have had a heart attack, by the way, you stood here tonight. But this, we'll be setting quite a pace with this. Something tiny. The 80s version of the car of the 60s, the British Leyland Mini City. There it is. Look at that. Hey. Okay. Here we are, Caroline, Kevin. Here you go. Man, come with me. That's it. Oh, gracious God.
Here
you go, Mandy. Congratulations to the pair of you. Wonderful. I tell you what, he was a second-hand car salesman. This is already second-hand, even though it's brand new. But don't worry, hey, you've got money. You won in the quiz. Susan Maughan has that. Susan, how much was it?
£560.
£560. There it is. Oh, congratulations to you, Mandy. Good luck, Kevin. Take care. Wonderful. Marvelous. There you go, Sue. Well, ladies and gentlemen, once again, End of another 3-2-1. Fabulous couples, great guest stars. See you next week. Have a good week, everybody. Bye-bye. Bye.